So everybody, Thunder and Diesel here. So this video is gonna be of me working my last day at Western Express, driving a semi truck. Gonna be delivering the last two loads. The first load was from Jackson, Georgia to Adairsville, Georgia. The Lowe's distribution center in Adairsville is next to Carsville. And from Adairsville, I forgot where we went, but we went to another place to pick up our very last load. We got there like at what, 9:30 p.m. It took like 2 hours to load up. We left there at 11:30. And from there we went to a truck stop, the TA truck stop in Cartersville, Georgia. Exit 296. So we took our last 10-hour break in that truck at the TA. And then from there we woke up. We went straight to the Western Express terminal in Nashville, Tennessee. We dropped off the trailer, dropped off the truck, said goodbye, and then we went home. We started a new dump trucking job in 2-3 days later. So y'all can check out that video of me driving a Peterbilt 386 dump truck. Come on. So y'all keep on watching, you're gonna see the POV of me just driving. I didn't talk back then, so. And I'm just gonna show some clips of some cool trucks that's on the road. And then we're gonna get there in a few minutes. Keep on. To that turbo, I'm the only one who has the least speed. Man, these GSP Dodge Chargers, man, they look so nice. Someday I'll buy it in the next GSP. I think they have Hellcats. Damn, they're so bad. It's gonna be a Freightliner Coronado hitting the jigs. It sounds so loud. And there's a cop chasing him. I'm just kidding. They're not let you hit the jigs. Man, look at this poor Peterbilt though, man. The super is all smashed up. Sounds so nice. Looks so nice too. This is gonna be the last truck clip today, and then we're gonna keep on trucking. That's a nice car hauler though. Come on. So here we're arriving at the shipper. Gonna pick up the last load. I didn't record that first load. I had the camera mounted outside, but now. Yeah, sorry about those black bars on the sides. It didn't record on full screen. It's not the regular resolution it should be at, but at least it recorded. bus a U-turn right quick. Back in for a dog for the last time. I don't know when the next time is coming, but hopefully soon with a big old beetle bug. Man, it wasn't a one shot back though. I have my tandems all the way back. It's kind of harder to back a trailer with the tandems all the way back. I had to retry, set up again. But we got it in, you know, without hitting off.
A few moments later.
It took about 2 hours to load. Now we're gonna pull out, check our tires, make sure everything's good, go get our paperwork, close the doors, put a seal on, and then head out. So yeah, I'm gonna pull the pins, we can slide our tandems back to the regular operating position so it's easier to make the turns, cause if I have my tandems all the way back like that, it's gonna be, I have to turn very wide. Yeah. I'm gonna keep on the lookout for this trailer 130084, the very last trailer I ever pulled. I wonder if it's still out there. It's a brand new trailer too, like it was clean and almost all the trailers at that company were all messed up. Bunch of holes, big rims, tires, and all that stuff. And a week before this, I had my truck all with lights and everything, looks nice, underglowing, but I had to take it off because it's already leaving, so I took everything out of the truck, my clothes, food, the lights I had, everything. So there's nothing in the truck, not even the blanket. I had to buy one at the truck stop so I can sleep. Yeah, sometimes I do miss driving this truck. It was pretty comfortable. It was pretty quick too. I had a Cummins X15. Like, I pulled up to exactly 80,000 pounds, no problem. In training, I drove a Freightliner with a Detroit. That thing was not good in hills, but this one, dang. Safety first, always wear a seatbelt. Now let's get a rolling. Let's go take our 10-hour break, so sleep. And now we're driving straight by the truck, man. I kinda miss driving this. Is pretty quiet. So sometimes I just want to hear silence. Maybe some. I kind of like the bowl, but maybe some day I get a bowl.
Turn left on Gullet Road, then turn right.
Thing I miss about driving a semi is making these wide turns. I don't know, I kind of like them. It was a challenge, it was fun. Big ass trailer, backing in the big ass trailer. It was pretty cool.
She's always waiting with two loving arms when I get home. She tells me that she's lonely every minute while I'm gone. She keeps begging me to quit this road, but I can't quit, that's true. 'Cause I was born to be a trucker, and that's all I wanna do. Well, I would like to work in town, but I can't, I'm afraid. 'Cause you can't get a job in town unless you've got a trade. And the only trade I know is driving these old trucks, it's true. 'Cause I was born to be a trucker, and that's all I wanna do. Born to be a trucker, driving this old truck across the nation. Born to be a trucker, that's my only occupation. I guess I'll keep on driving these trucks till I get old. 'Cause it's the only way of living this poor boy knows. Well, I could have been a businessman if I'd just gone to school. But I was born to be a trucker, and that's all I wanna do. Born to be a trucker, driving this old truck across the nation. Born to be a trucker, that's my only occupation. I guess I'll keep on driving these old trucks till I get old, 'cause it's the only way of living this poor boy knows. Well, I could have been a businessman if I'd just gone to school, but I was born to be a trucker, and that's all I wanna do. I was born to be a trucker, and that's all I wanna do.
Alright, so in that last clip, I ran out of space in my SD card, but I switched to a new one in the morning. Now I'm getting out of my truck, do my pre-trip, check everything through. I always make sure. I know, check my airlines, nobody messed with my stuff. Check my team pin, hope nobody pulled my pin, so my trailer don't fall off.
Nasty truckers,
bro. Yeah, some drivers out there are nasty, man. They crap in bags, just leave it in the parking lots. They throw the trash away in the parking lot. This is why they don't like truckers, man. Like, man, there's people that make us look bad out there. So yeah, I gotta check all the lights, my blinkers work, mouth flaps don't come off. Check all my lug nuts, my tires, we're all good. Let's get rolling. Just gonna park over here right quick. I need to go use the restroom, brush my teeth. It was a pretty far walk where I was parked at, so I'm gonna go inside and we'll get back on the road.
on the road again. Just can't wait to get on the road again. The life I love is making music with my friends, and I can't wait to get on the road again. On the road again. Going places that I've never been, seeing things that I may never see again. I can't wait to get on the road again. On the road again. Like a band of gypsies, we go down the highway. We're the best of friends, insisting that the world keep turning our way. And our way is on the road again. I just can't wait to get on the road.
Now I'm looking in my mirror and I see a Peterbilt 362 cab over coming, so I had to record this, you know. Thing I hated about this truck was that beeping, man. It was annoying. It's like, oh, you're getting too close to the vehicle in front of you. It's like, no shit, I can see. Right now we're climbing Montego, Tennessee. Gonna go up this big ass mountain. And we're gonna stop at the rest area at the top, check everything, take a little leak, take a picture of my truck. And then we're gonna go downhill. We're gonna be using the Jakes. Oh, fuck. Going very slow, cause we don't wanna crash, you know.
fucking on it.
Man, like I said earlier, man, this Cummins X15 pulled really good when I passed all these trucks up this hill. I think I wasn't even loaded that much. Oh, y'all saw earlier the trailer was full, but it's light though. I wonder what, I don't remember what it was, but yeah, passing all these slow ass trucks. So we're at the rest area, now we're leaving to use the restroom, get a little snack, took the last picture of the truck, and let's go down here.
That Swift
came out. First started working for this company, when I was in training with my trainer, we went up and down this hill like what, 2-3 times a week, man. He was kind of local, just running Georgia, Tennessee back and forth, going down this Mount Eagle. The jake bricks on that DD15 actually sounded nice, man. On this one, the Cummins X15, you can barely hear it, man. And when I was riding through here in training, there was a lot of trucks going fast down the hill. I'm like, man, y'all are dumb. One day your brakes are gonna fail, or your jake brakes won't work good, and you're gonna crash. Always gotta get down here slow, jake brakes on high.
You heard about the pigeon of Jesse James, John Henry, just to mention some names. Well, there's a truck driving legend in the South today, a man called Bandit from Atlanta, GA. Ever hear a gentleman knows his name? They swear he got ice water running in his veins. A foot like lead and nerves like steel, he's gonna go to glory riding 18 wheels. Oh boy, he left Atlanta back in 63, hauling him a load up to Tennessee. He hit Mount Eagle in a driving rain, so hard he couldn't even see the passing lane. Well, he started down the freeway and he lost the gear. He hit them brakes, found he had nowhere. The Mount Eagle grade is steep and long, and ever pounded the scene and thought the bandit was gone. Well, his truck jackknife turned completely around. He was coming down back about the speed of sound. A lot of folks seen him and they all say he had his head out the windy hill and clear the way. Well, he got to the bottom safe and sound. Everybody asked Bandit how he made it down. He said, folks, when the truck picked up too much speed, I just run along beside it and drug my feet. You heard the legend of Jesse James and John Henry, just to mention some names. Well, there's a truck driving legend in the South today, a man called Bandit from Atlanta, GA. Every year, gentleman knows his name. He swear he's got eyes for the running in his veins. A foot like lead and nerve like steel. He's going up to glory riding 18 wheels. Oh, tell me. Talk to me.
right here to the left is a Peterbilt dealership. You can see the sign has a truck. It's pretty cool. It's Nitro Truck on the sign. Alright, so now we're taking the last exit, the Western Express terminals over here. We're gonna go park the truck, drop the trailer first, then go park the truck at the front. I'ma just leave it there. I think that's what I did. I just left it there. Went inside, gave him the keys, like, hey man, I'm leaving now. It's the first time I've ever seen this. It's called my driver manager, DM. It's kind of like my boss. It's the first time I met him. When I started, it was a different guy. I didn't meet that guy, but it's a new guy. Said, hey, nice to meet you, man, but I'ma leave now. So thanks for the work. And goodbye. So after we dropped the truck off, we called a Uber because I got a ticket for a Greyhound bus back to Atlanta. And but first, they weren't loading up to like 3 more hours. So first, I went to explore downtown Nashville. I just walked. I found a place to eat some chicken tenders, drink a few adult apple juices. You know what I mean? Pretty good. Relaxed. Shit, I should have talked to girls. You know, I'm shy. So. Yeah, we went back to Atlanta. When I got to Atlanta, that Greyhound bus station, man, there's a bunch of drug dealers. I said, hey man, you want some weed? And he actually had some, and there were cops right in front of us too. Man, what the fuck, y'all are crazy. They're crazy down in Atlanta, man. I was like, nah man, I don't smoke that shit. But yeah, we went back home. We started a new job like, 3 days later. Damn, it's been a long time since I came to the Western Express terminal. It was like 6 months ago. The first time I ever got the truck. That's the last time I ever went in it. So the speed limit here is like 5 miles an hour, so I'm gonna speed it up. First, let me know if you watched the whole thing. Comment down below. Tennessee, let me know if you watched the whole thing, man. I wanna know, cause I spent a lot of time editing. This is my first time actually like editing a video on PC. Well, the second one actually, but this is the first time doing a long one, man. I started what, like right now it's like 9:55 right now. Started like 5 hours ago already, man. It takes a long time to edit, but time went quick. It's actually kind of nice. But let me know if you watched the whole thing, just so I don't waste my time editing, because you know. All right, so this is gonna be my very last time backing up a semi truck. Just watch my skills. One shot. I'm a professional. Can't wait to drive a semi, you know. taking off the power line, the airlines. Unhook the trailer. And this trailer is different from the other one. Normally they have the landing gear where you crank the landing gear on the other side. I mean, on this side, the driver's side. But this one has it another side. So walk over there and drop the trailer. And they found everything that's wrong with the trailer when they first came in. Like, yo, this tire's bad, this tire's bad. Crack windshield. And the crack windshield happened from the rock, but the tires, you know, the tires. And I never crashed the truck, and all the damage that you see, like, broken, the broken hood and missing pieces of a bumper, that's already like that. So, having that pictures to prove. Yeah. So, thanks for watching. Like and subscribe if you want. Let me know if you watch the whole thing, you want the longer videos. Someday then I'll drive a semi-truck again, maybe a Peterbilt or a dream truck. For now, let's keep on dumb trucking. Come on.